I'm Denise Melito, and I've been working on the Living Breast Artist Series since February of this year. And what it is a fundraiser for breast cancer. My two friends were diagnosed in January, and my mom is a survivor of breast cancer. And I wanted to do something in order to help the cause. I was out with my friend Helen Cameron and Patty Calandrea, and Patty had just been diagnosed with breast cancer, and we were taking her out to support her and going to kind of cheer her up and look at some art. And so while I was out that night, I noticed some really beautiful breast images in the artwork. And it was like a light bulb went off in my head, and I heard a voice say, "Well, Denise, you're an artist, what are you going to do?" And so I said, "You know, Patty, I could paint breasts." And she said, "Yeah, and lay them out like in a calendar." And I'm like, "Yeah."
Tell us about your model today. Who do we see?
Leanne. We saw Leanne today. And the first painting that I did with her was extremely powerful because she was telling me about her mother.
My mother died of breast cancer very young. And I've never really had much of an opportunity to express how I feel about it, or to kind of give what my mother went through a voice. And it was such an ugly, ravaging disease, and this idea of doing a calendar is just such a beautiful way to honor women's bodies in spite of how they may have been ravaged by the disease. And I really wanted to be a part of it because of that.
So do you get tested quite often now?
I get my mammogram once a year, and then I do the self-exam every month. Mm-hmm. I started feeling guilty for not doing it at first because I thought it was kind of, that would really hurt my family, mm-hmm. considering our history.
The process of her death took like 6 months from diagnosis until she made her transition. And that was a very emotional painting for me because I felt her mother's presence in the room with us during that time, and our conversation was so intimate and so personal, and without any sort of relationship behind us to support this.
You'd never met her before?
I'd never met her before, and that was a painting where I actually had tears in my eyes for most of the painting, and I felt such a love and respect for Leanne for participating and for opening up herself so much to me, a total stranger. And it made me realize, that was one of the paintings where I realized that this project had nothing to do with me. This project had to do with each woman who participated. They all had their personal reasons, and they needed this expression. It gave them something concrete and something active they could do with around their loss.
Is this me?
So Katie, is this you?
That is me.
Yes. So I feel like I've been here as well.
So excited.
It really is.
Is that you?
It is me.
Oh my God!
Oh, look, they put us next to each other. I'm like, oh, that is me.
Oh, isn't that cool?
Oh yeah, I hadn't
awesome.
Seen that one.
What was interesting about Cindy is that we made an appointment for her painting, and then she secured some work. So she canceled her appointment and sent her friend Katie, who also ended up being part of the project.
I'm sure I tried to sell it to you because
right.
I knew she'd be a little resistant.
not resistant,
but to the idea of it.
Nervous. Yeah, it's not something I would have normally done.
Right.
Kind of a new idea.
Exactly.
And then I was completely confused at first.
Yes.
Because when they said you're going to paint your breasts,
confused.
I thought that I didn't know that they were physically painting on
you.
My breasts. Me at first, I thought you were sitting for a painting of your breasts.
Oh.
And so I'm imagining sitting there for hours being a nude still model.
And so then, I had my appointment that day and talked with her afterwards, and then Cindy came to the realization, she's like, wait, they painted your breast, like, on your body? Yeah!
Like, I'm kind of ticklish.